I'm on the road today as Nikki the cat, who is safely tucked in her carrier. Her and I are taking a ride down to University of Illinois, small animal hospital. I'm driving a 2019 F-150 that I picked up from a rental agency just for a day because I wanted to try one. This is about a 5-hour round trip for me, all highway. Well, it's a good time to see what all the noise about. Everybody seems to like these trucks, and I will tell you, I'm quite impressed. This one's got 11,000 miles on it, so it's positively been used, and being a rental, you know, it doesn't necessarily have an easy life. First got into it yesterday, and the first thing I thought was happening, I'd come to a stoplight, and I'd feel the thing stutter like it wanted to quit. I didn't realize I had to defeat the auto start feature that's on a 2019. I don't have that on my vehicle. I drive with 2 feet, so as I come up to a stoplight, I'd feel the thing stutter a little bit like it was going to quit, and instinctively I would just slightly feather the throttle so it would prevent it from shutting off. Completely forgot that it had auto start, and a couple times I think it did shut off briefly. You touch the pedal, of course, it starts right back up. I never heard a starter motor. You don't hear the engine starting. I'm quite surprised. Regardless, auto start is an asinine feature, and I know it's done strictly to pacify EPA regulations trying to squeeze a little more fuel economy out of it. Anyway, that's just my opinion. Overall, the truck is quite enjoyable to drive. Seating is comfortable. View of the instruments, it's hard to see with the sunlight, but got a good view of the instrumentation. I love the fact it has a transmission temperature gauge on the right. These are supposed to have pretty good towing capacity. I don't remember the numbers right now. My buddy Jerry would be a little disappointed at me because I should know those numbers. He talks about these trucks all the time. I want to get back to the operation with the 3.5 liter Ecoboost and the 10-speed transmission. I would have been leery to buy one of these. After driving it, it works well. You don't feel the thing shifting much past third speed range. Third to fourth, you'll know is happening. After that, unless you're watching the tachometer, you don't know it's shifting. There's an indicator that'll show up on the dashboard. It actually tells you what gear you're in. But overall, it is quite smooth, better than I expected it would be. And you get it up to speed, it gets up to 10th real fast and stays there. Unless you stomp down on the throttle at a hill, if you're on cruise control like I am, and I'm running at 72, you hit a hill, you'll hear the turbo spool up a little bit, and it's pretty quiet, but you can hear it. I don't see the tachometer change at all, nor does the speedometer change. You don't lose any speed, and it doesn't downshift. I suppose if you hit a high enough hill or headwinds, yeah, it might downshift. But overall, real nice driving truck. I'm very impressed. The steering wheel controls are laid out sensibly, as are the rest of the controls. The large display on the media center / controls is quite visible. They were smart enough to make it big for people like me that have a hard time reading little tiny stuff. Overall information is good. Nice truck, very nice. I don't have a need for the 4 doors. I would much rather have 2 doors and a full-size bed. That's just personal for me. Overall, very nice. We'll see what the fuel economy's like, but I think they're supposed to get 17, 18 miles a gallon at least on the highway. I could be wrong, it could be more than that. So that's where we're at today. And I'm about 45 minutes from the university, so please wish Nikki well. She's going to be seeing an oncologist today. Well, we have arrived out at the university. Hey, Nikki, what did you think of the F-150? I think she was unimpressed, but she slept almost all the way. So anyway, we're here. We're going to take a walk in, see if they can do something.